As far as West Bengal is concerned, we have declared our renewable energy policy in the year 2012. Before that, we don't have any renewable energy policy. And in 2013, our regulation has also come from State Electricity Regulatory Commission. And at the same time, our draft industrial policy for the state is also in the website at present. That is draft only. But West Bengal is doing some pioneering job in solar. We have country's first megawatt level project, grid connected, that is running in Asansol. That is, the capacity is 2 megawatt. Apart from West Bengal Renewable Energy Development Agency, we have another company called Green Energy Development Corporation. That is also a government company. And I am also heading that company. You know, one thing I believe personally, that subsidy-driven program cannot be sustainable. It should be in the market mode. You know, I know one guy in Malda district. He resigned from his government service. He is an IPS officer. He started his business in renewable energy sectors 5 years back. And he never participated in any tender which is subsidy driven. He is completely going through market mode, and his growth rate is around, say, more than 60%. And we are very close to each other. And he believes that subsidy-driven program never be sustainable. Because, you know, government can withdraw subsidy at any time, can impose subsidy at any time, can change the subsidy pattern at any time, can introduce new subsidy-driven schemes. So some business may hamper. But if it is in the market mode, okay, market-driven price will dictate. And finally, it will be, you know, in a sustainable manner. But still, it is accepted that subsidy-driven program means presently it is financially not that much viable. That is why subsidy is provided. So we are also giving some subsidy along with MNRE, but case-to-case basis. You know, in West Bengal, the population density is highest per square kilometer, because most of our land is very much fertile. So we have some land problem, though we are now thinking that we should install 150 megawatt wind power project at East Midnapur. It is in the coastal area, though we don't have very much wind potential, but we have our off-grid wind projects and grid-connected wind projects in Fraser Ganj. And you know, our priority is rooftop, and as per our regulation, the minimum capacity should be 5 kilowatt. And day before yesterday, I had a discussion with defense, that army people, GOC Bengal, and the army people will come in a very big way in West Bengal as per rooftop power plant is concerned, both in net metering concept and as well as in, you know, battery backup concept. Because we have also supplied some power plant in the border areas in West Bengal, because, you know, we have some 2 international borders. One is Nepal, another is Bangladesh. So to Shima Surakha Bal, it is SSB, we have supplied some solar power plants, and it is working well. And we have some 16 numbers of mini-grid power plants in the remote islands of Sundarbans. And the unique feature of West Bengal is, West Bengal is a power surplus state. We don't have that much of power cut and load shed and this, that. So net metering is the way to proceed further in renewable energy sector. And I personally believe that net metering is a win-win situation, both for DISCOM as per RPO is concerned, especially in solar sector, and at the same time the consumers. And finally, the subsidy will go to the owner of the plant or owner of the project. The developers will get their money back, whether it comes from the subsidy or from the owner's pocket. So subsidy should be there. I agree with it at present, the situation, as per the situation of the renewable energy, but finally it should be in the market model. You know, another thing is very important. Our DISCOM, especially West Bengal State Electricity Distribution Company, is a profit-making organization. So it is very tough to make one power purchase agreement with SEDCL, but once it is done, your payment is rest assured within time. No delayed payment, no this, that. Your payment will be rest assured, WBSEDCL is scoring first for last 3 years as per the best DISCOM in India. And we have our solar housing complex also. And recently, Honorable Kolkata High Court has passed one order based on one public interest litigation case. And that government order clearly indicates that every building should have their solar system, whether it is solar thermal, I mean the solar hot water system, or it is through net metering. So we are also taking up this matter with the Municipal Affairs Department. In fact, 2-3 days earlier, I had a discussion with the Principal Secretary, Municipal Affairs Department, and West Bengal will come up in a very big way as far as net metering rooftop is concerned.